was just such an honor to have the executive director of the Quilts of Valor Foundation visit us at the Joe Brown Senior Center here in Anderson. We're adding a third room, expanding, and it was the perfect time for her to be here and meet some of our quilters and them get to meet her.
We're going to move to a unique pin every year. It sounds like collector pins might be interesting to people. So this is the 2019 Executive Director pin.
We got a lot of questions answered today. Things that I never would have thought to ask that she had in her speech. So it was just great having her here.
But I'm on a couple of missions. One is to help y'all get fabric, batting, notions, supplies, materials, brochures, postcards, all the things that you need to do.
You would hope that every group in the nation would have this opportunity, but I'm sure they won't because it's, I think there's 600 groups.
So I'm on a mission for the next 2 years to visit as many groups as I can. The groups have asked for better communication and they've asked for more input from the executive director. So I'm going to provide that as best as possible. Obviously, it's easier to get to places that I can drive to within a couple hours. But other than Alaska and Hawaii, in the next 2 years, I'll be in your state. My home base is currently South Carolina. However, I am moving to Winterset. We are opening our corporate headquarters there. We've never had a corporate headquarters, and now is the time. It'll be located in Winterset, within a block of the Iowa Quilt Museum. And also, that is the home of Mary Ann Fonz, and she was an early champion of our organization, and I think it's right that that's where we start. The great thing about Quilts of Valor is, from day one, this has resonated with the hearts of people. We're in a time where those that served during the Vietnam vet era were not thanked when they came back and may have been mistreated. All of us can remember that, and we want to ensure that today's modern soldier, who has volunteered and was not drafted, is thanked, as well as those that still survive who were drafted. This is a tangible way to show our gratitude and to also offer them comfort and healing for any trials or tribulations or wounds that they may suffer during their service. And I believe the reason that this is spread is that there are 1.2 million quilters, and each of them can envision making at least one Quilt of Valor. And they are a very extroverted, talkative group who have large social circles, and they talk to their friends, and their friends listen to the story, and they decide, I can make one too.
We thank you for your service, your sacrifice, and your valor in serving our nation. Last, we hope your quilt provides healing, peace, and comfort. Please know you are forever in our thoughts and our hearts. The 6 years, October the 21st, is when I received my Quilt of Valor. And after I got mine, that's all I've done since then, basically, is make more Quilt of Valor for veterans.
We are the beginnings of hope for some people.
Quilt of Valor Foundation wishes to recognize you for your service to our nation. We consider it a privilege to honor you. Though we may never know the extent of your sacrifice and service to protect and defend the United States of America, as an expression of gratitude, we award you this Quilt of Valor.
Thank you. Thank you so very much. Welcome home. Let me salute y'all.
Thank you.